Hello viewers, you have tuned into my channel BioHub. I welcome you all. I hope you all are fine and doing good at your place. Dear viewers, you know we are on chapter number 1, crop production and management. And today, I have something special to show you. See, few days back when I was teaching you sowing, I have planted few seeds and now see, they have grown up and reached to the stage of seedling. Now it's time to give them some nutrient supplement, and for that I have this nutrient supplement. It is called vermicompost. Come on, let's learn little more about this step, manuring. Let's learn biology. Students, this is our chapter number 1, crop production and management. We are covering this chapter part wise, and today we have to cover its fourth part. In this part, you will come to know about one very important step in the process of crop production or farming, and that is step number 4, manuring. So this is the general layout of this chapter. We can divide this chapter in basically 5 parts. We are already through with part number 1, agriculture, its meaning, history and basic classification of crops. You can watch video of this segment on my channel BioHub. We have started segment 2 also, and it is about methods of crop production. So in this we have covered first 3 steps. First one was preparation of soil. In the second, we have seen how selection of seeds is done. And in the third step, we came to know about sowing. And today, our focus is on step number 4, manuring. And the learning objective of this video is, firstly, we will have a quick recap of steps of crop production. Then our focus will be on step 4, manuring. The last segment of this video is about a comparative account of 2 terms, manure and fertilizer. So this is the learning objective of this video, steps of crop production. In the first step, we came to know about the preparation of soil. In the second step, we came to know how farmer is going for the selection of seeds. Third step enabled us to know about the process of sowing, and today we have to know about this fourth step, manuring, in detail. Fifth step is irrigation, sixth weeding, and seventh it's protection from pest and diseases. Eighth step is harvesting, threshing and winnowing, and lastly step number 9, storage. So these are the basic steps in the process of crop production or farming. So students, here also we are going for a virtual tour of the field, and we are going to see ourselves what the farmer is doing when he is going for manuring of the field. So are you ready? Okay. Manuring is the process or a method to maintain the fertility of the soil. Aur ye fertility kaise maintain hogi? By maintaining the nutrients in the soil, ताकि वो सारे nutrients plants को उनकी requirement के हिसाब से continuously मिलते जाएं. और ये nutrients क्या है? Nutrients वो elements हैं जो plant को अपना basic growth और development के लिए चाहिए. And few of these are nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. Continuous cultivation of crops, it is reducing the nutrient content of the soil, and this reduces the future crop produced. अब इस स्टेज पे फार्मर के पास 2 ऑप्शंस हैं. फर्स्ट ऑप्शन है कि वो नेचुरल मेथड से सॉइल की फर्टिलिटी को रीप्लानिश करे, रीस्टोर करे, और दूसरा मैनुअल मेथड है, फील्ड में कुछ ऐसी चीजें डाले जिससे सॉइल का फर्टिलिटी या वो न्यूट्रिएंट्स का अमाउंट फिर से वापस रिस्टोर हो जाए. Under natural methods, we have further 3 types. First one is field fallow, second is crop rotation, and third one is mixed cropping. Coming to manual methods of manuring, we have again 2 methods. First one is natural supplements or organic supplements, and second option is synthetic supplements. Under natural supplements, we do have 3 more options, and these are green manure, compost and vermicompost, and under synthetic we have one option, that is fertilizer. So these are the different methods which can be used by a farmer to replenish the nutrients in the soil or to maintain the fertility of the soil. This is the flow chart of different methods of manuring. Let's know about natural methods of manuring or replenishment of nutrients in the soil. First natural method is field fallow. A field fallow is that field which is not cultivated by the farmer for one or more seasons to allow the field to regain its fertility. So now pay attention to this picture, students. In this picture, you can see there are two fields, one in which crop is growing and another which is completely empty. So this is field fallow. Farmer is not growing his crop on one part of the land for one or more seasons in order to allow this field to regain its fertility naturally. But farmer may go for plowing and maintaining of that field. So this is first natural method of restoring the fertility of the soil. Second is crop rotation. Students, crop rotation ko samjhane se pehle main ek aapko kissa sunati hu. Ab imagine kariye ek office hai jisme teen shift mein log, teen different log kaam karne aate hain aur wo khana bhi usi office mein khate hain. Unke office mein bhi fridge hai jisme vegetarian, non-vegetarian food aur sweet dish hai. फ्रिज में भरा हुआ है और उनकी मर्जी उन्होंने क्या खाना. जो फर्स्ट शिफ्ट के लिए पर्सन आता है उसको स्वीडिश पसंद, तो फ्रिज में जितना स्वीडिश है वो खा लेता है. सेकंड शिफ्ट में जो बंदा आता है उसको नॉनवेज फूड पसंद है, तो वो फ्रिज खोलता है सेकंड शिफ्ट में, वो काम भी करता है, वो खाना भी खा लेता है. थर्ड शिफ्ट वाला जो पर्सन है उसको दाल चावल पसंद है, तो फ्रिज में वो भी पड़ा हुआ है तो वो दाल चावल खाता है. क्या हुआ, दिन में तीन लोग आए शिफ्ट में काम करने के लिए और तीनों के लिए खाना पड़ा हुआ था और उन्होंने अपना अपना खाना खा लिया, कोई भी भूखा नहीं रहा. इसी तरह सॉइल में भी डिफरेंट टाइप के न्यूट्रिएंट्स हैं. सो इन द सेम वे क्रॉप रोटेशन में भी सिमिलर चीज होती है. इट इन्वॉल्व्स ग्रोइंग डिफरेंट क्रॉप्स अल्टरनेटिवली ऑन द सेम फील्ड सो दैट द सॉइल इज नॉट डिप्लीटेड ऑफ एनी पर्टिकुलर न्यूट्रिएंट्स. Farmer knows the nutritional requirement of the crop and he plants the crops accordingly. For example, if the farmer is planting rice in the first year, then in the second year he will plant cotton, and in the third year farmer is going to plant soybeans. Such rotation of the crops is not only fulfilling the nutritional requirement of each crop but also enabling the soil to replenish its nutrients naturally. Third natural method of manuring or going for restoring the fertility of the soil is mixed cropping. In mixed cropping, two or more crops are grown together. Crops are chosen such that the nutritional needs of one crop are fulfilled by another. And we have a long list of examples. Like wheat and peas are grown together. Cotton and groundnut can be cultivated in the same field in same season. And this is the field where maize and beans, they are growing together. So this is mixed cropping. But इसमें farmer क्या ध्यान में रखता है students? कि जो भी वो crops लगा रहा है उनका nutritional requirement same ना हो. अगर same होगा then they will start competing with each other and the crop yield will drastically go down. Although these natural methods of manuring are slow but they are helping in restoring the soil fertility without creating any imbalance. Now coming to next type, manual methods of replenishment of nutrients in the soil. So here also farmer has two options. First one is manure and the second one is fertilizer. Manures are of organic origin and fertilizers are of inorganic origin. Manure. Manure is made up of decomposition of dead and decaying plants and animal waste. Like I have a flower pot. In this also we have dead and decaying organic matter. Dead leaves are there, so this is organic matter. Manure is made by decomposition of dead and decaying plants and animal waste. This decomposed material is rich in organic matter. Organic matter means which is of living origin. We have three types of manure. So we have three options in manure when we are manually adding certain supplements in the soil to increase the fertility. First option is green manure, second is compost, and third is vermicompost. So let's learn about green manure. This is very interesting, students. Shayad aap mein se कईयों के लिए ये नई बात होगी. मैन्योर, जब भी ये टर्म आती है मैन्योर, तो हम क्या सोचते हैं कि सिर्फ डेड डीकम्पोज्ड ऑर्गेनिक मैटर इज यूज्ड एज मैन्योर. वी हैव ग्रीन मैन्योर्स आल्सो, जहां पे लिविंग प्लांट को ही फ्लो करके सॉइल में डाल दिया जाता है और वो नेचुरली डीकम्पोज्ड होके सॉइल की फर्टिलिटी को बढ़ाता है. इट इज मेड फ्रॉम क्रॉप grown specifically to be plowed in the soil while still green to improve the fertility of the soil. So har koi crop ko hum green manure mein nahi use karte. There are specific crops jo soil ki fertility ko actually increase karti hain. The farmer is raising those crops before sowing his main crop, and then while plowing the field he is plowing those plants. They are getting buried, and examples are legumes jo सॉइल का नाइट्रोजन कंटेंट बढ़ाते हैं, राई ग्रास, फेनिग्रिक एक्सेट्रा. सो दीज क्रॉप्स दे आर कॉल्ड ग्रीन मैन्योर. नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी इज कंपोस्ट. यू हैव बेसिक आइडिया अबाउट दिस. कंपोस्ट द प्रोसेस्ड फॉर्म ऑफ मैन्योर मेड बाय बरिंग डेड और डिकेइंग प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल वेस्ट इन अ पिट विद ऑल्टरनेट लेयर्स ऑफ सॉइल एंड लीविंग इट टू रॉट. अपनी फील्ड में एक गड्ढा खोदता है, उसमें जितने भी क्रॉप रेजिड्यू है, काउडंग है, तो उस गड्ढे में डालता है. देन वन लेयर ऑफ सॉइल प्लेस करता है, अगेन क्रॉप रेजिड्यू, एनिमल वेस्ट, अनदर लेयर ऑफ सॉइल एंड लाइक वाइज. सो वट एवर इज ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक ओरिजिन इट इज थ्रोन इन दैट इन लेयर and it is left there to rot. A large number of bacteria and fungi are there in that layer of soil, and they speed up the process of decomposition. That decomposed organic matter is called humus. This is dead decaying organic matter. Now let's learn about humus also. Humus makes the soil fertile by providing organic nutrients. It is dark brown in color. It improves the texture of the soil. It has many other advantages also. It prevents soil erosion. It increasing the water holding capacity of the soil. It provides food to earthworm and a large number of other microbes which are residing in the soil. So this was about compost. Third method of manual manuring is vermicomposting. In this method, earthworms are used during composting to enhance the process of decomposition of organic matter. This process is also called as vermiculture. So vermiculture mein hota kya hai, students? In vermicomposting, in addition to bacteria and fungi, we are adding earthworms also. And these earthworms, they are enhancing or speeding up the process of decomposition of organic matter, and the compost which is produced by the earthworms is much more rich in nutrients. Now, students, this simple living organism is not only helping the farmer in making manual manure to supplement the fertility of the soil, but it is also doing many other things in its own way. And that's why Mr. Earthworm is also called as farmer's friend or nature's gardener. They improve the texture of the soil. They make burrows in the soil and allow air to enter into it and water to drain out from that. They form channels in the soil by moving in and out, and it enables the plant to spread its roots. Students, many of our farmers are using vermicompost. A few of the farmers, they are also setting up vermicomposting units at their place. Like this is one of the vermicompost pit set up in a village by a farmer, and they are making vermicompost. Students, you know that the human population on this planet Earth is increasing at a very fast rate, and to meet the food requirement of ever-growing population, farmer cannot depend on natural methods or organic supplements. He has to go for inorganic supplements also. So what are these inorganic supplements which are helping increasing the crop productivity? They all come under fertilizers. So fertilizers, they are synthetic or man-made materials that are added to the soil to provide the plant with the nutrients they need. Fertilizers are a better source of nutrients for the plant. What you have to remember, fertilizers, they are rich in three nutrients, nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium, which is required by the plant in large amount. So, agar hum ye plant ko dete hain, to uska growth speed up ho jayega. Productivity bahut achha rahega. Crop yield badh jayega. So, farmer is going for use of fertilizers also, but they are of inorganic origin. Agar humne inko properly handle nahi kiya, then there will be imbalance on this planet. But the farmer is using these. So why the farmer is using these? Let's see. These fertilizers, they are not harmful as long as they are utilized in the recommended quantity. So the fertilizer should be used and handled very carefully. So in order to make up our mind whether we have to go for fertilizers, we have to go for organic methods, let's make a comparative account. This comparison will enable us to analyze and interpret the importance of manure as well as fertilizer and their requirement. So first thing is, we know manures, they are of organic origin. Fertilizers are inorganic substances. Wo factory mein banaye jaate hain. Second point is, manure provides all the essential nutrients to the soil. Fertilizer, they provide specific nutrients to the soil. Agar nitrogen chahiye, to nitrogen dala jayega. Agar potassium chahiye, potassium. Thirdly, manures, their action is slow and fertilizers are fast. Fourth point, manure adds humus to the soil, whereas fertilizer does not add any humus to the soil. Fifth point is, manure is required in very large amount to see the desired effect, that is to see the increase in the crop production. Whereas fertilizers, they are required in very small quantity and they help in boosting up the crop yield. Sixth point is, manure is difficult to store and transport because manure is required in bulk, whereas fertilizers, they are required in very less quantity. So it's very easy to store and transport these. Manure is biodegradable. It is not creating any imbalance in the field or in the nature. Fertilizers, they are not biodegradable. Lastly, manure is prepared in the field. And you know, the fertilizers, they are prepared in the factories. So this is the comparative account of manure and fertilizer. So that's it about step 4, manuring. Let's summarize. In this video, we did a quick recap of steps of crop production. We slipped into farmer's boot and went to the field to see the various methods of manuring. While learning about methods of manuring, we came to know about manure and fertilizer, and we made a comparative account of these two. We also found out the logic behind the use of fertilizers by the farmer. I'm sure this term manuring and methods of manuring are clear to you. Now it's time for bonus. I'm supplementing this video with one worksheet for self-assessment. These questions will indirectly help you to prepare for the exams. And next time, whenever you will tune into my channel, I'm coming up with next 3 steps in the process of crop production or farming, and these are irrigation, weeding, and protection from pests and diseases. So it's time to wind up this video. Thanks a lot for watching my channel and appreciating the content of my videos. So it's a bye-bye from your facilitator, Dr. Seema Sharma. Please like karna, subscribe karna, or share karna mat bhoolna. Bye-bye.